lead busy lives, and sometimes stress can get the best of us. But there are ways you can relax and de-stress in just minutes. Back with us today is the fitness nomad John Ashworth to explain why 5 minutes of yoga could make all of the difference.
Right.
So the first thing we need to know is, what are the benefits of yoga?
The benefits of yoga are many, and I've been really in tune with these lately because I have been doing more yoga to take care of an injured back and knee. So the benefits are improved focus, improved strength, improved flexibility, improved mood. They go on and on. Already said focus, mood, flexibility, strength. That's one people don't think about. And posture, that's a big one. It really helps improve posture. And there's the list goes on about double on my blog on those two.
Yeah, so we'll link you up to that if you want to keep reading, because there are more than five benefits. Now, this idea for this segment stems from a recent article that you read
right. That
said that more people are doing yoga at the airport.
Right. I thought this was great. This really is what I call being a fitness nomad, doing it anywhere. So people are doing it at the airport when they have downtime. The airport is a great place. You're under a lot of stress, time, crunch, all this kind of stuff. So people are in the airport doing yoga.
Now, I know what some of you are thinking right now. Immediately you go, there is no way I would draw that kind of attention to myself.
Right.
That would be embarrassing.
Right.
So is this legitimate? I mean, we can actually do this at the airport. We can do it anywhere without causing a scene.
Right. Well, you're only as embarrassed as you let yourself be. So that's something to remember. But if you really can't get yourself to do it at the airport, there are some resources I put on my blog. You can download yoga classes onto your iPhone from the internet, and you can do it anywhere you feel comfortable. So if you can't quite get over that feeling of self-consciousness at the airport, you know, do it somewhere else.
And in 3 to 5 minutes, it might not be the most advanced move, so maybe you're not going to feel as embarrassed as you think you might. You have a 3 to 5 minute routine you're going to preview for us.
Right.
So let's just quickly zip through.
Quick sequence here.
Okay.
And you're going to start actually standing. You're going to reach up in the air. Reach out and over into a nice forward bend, good for the hamstrings and the hips. Then you're going to step one leg back, one leg in between your hands. We call this the high leg lunge, looking up, great for the hips. Stepping the other leg back, going into that downward dog, another big stretch for the hamstrings. Then the other foot comes forward in between the hands. Left leg is up, again into that high leg lunge. You're
so
really going to
feel
this.
It's a lot of
this.
Looking up and then down. So you want to think about your head, too, as you're doing this.
That's right. Other foot comes forward, back into that forward bend, and then if you need to for your back, you bend your legs, and you come up. That's one sequence. You can go around and around and around on that for as much time as you have, and you'd be surprised what that'll do for you in 3 to 5 minutes.
All right, so the downward dog, you know, maybe a little flashy for the airport, but you could always kind of go to a corner, because you know how sometimes there are these little alcoves at airports?
Absolutely.
So
right.
Find what makes you comfortable. John, thank you. And if you would
Welcome.
Like to read John's blog on the benefits of yoga and how you can practice it anywhere, log on to our web channel and click on News Links.